Good morning, students. I'm here to explain an experiment which belongs to section B, and that is spotting. So here you can see, students, this is section B, spotting. So today's spot is to study the pedigree charts of genetic traits such as hemophilia, sickle cell anemia, rolling of tongue, blood clots. So these are the genetic traits, some are disorders over here, which can be studied by pedigree charts. So in board examination, you are given such type of charts. You are supposed to study such charts, and then some questions being asked on these charts, and you are supposed to give answers on these charts. So here you can see, students, I have made some charts so on the slide, so you can go through each and every chart. Let us study different charts. First of all, we must know what is pedigree. See, pedigree is a chart which consists of different symbols. Some are square, some are rectangular, some are circles. They are attached with each other, they are linked with each other by horizontal and vertical lines, and they represent generations, so that we can study some traits which are inherited from one generation to next generation. So students, in this pedigree chart, here you can see, a pedigree chart is a record of certain genetic traits for two or more generations, presented in the form of a diagram, which we call a family tree. And here you can see, the study of pedigree charts is known as pedigree analysis. So here, let us start with the symbols. What are the symbols? As I said, some symbols are used to make the pedigree charts. So what are the symbols used to make the pedigree chart? So here you can see, there are some common symbols I am going to explain. For example, by the help of square, we represent male. By the help of circle, we represent female. Here the numbers, the big sex unspecified. Here is the proband. Proband means here the first time the trait is seen in the generation. If we shade the symbols, the square and the circles, it means affected individuals. If it is half shade, it means carrier of a particular trait. And if it is shaded in this way, it means the trait is autosomal. It means the gene for particular trait is present on autosomes. And here you can see, if dot is given, it is also a carrier, but the gene is present on X chromosome. Now diseased. Diseased means death. If here the square is a diagonal line is, or you can say a line is drawn crossing the, you can say, square, then it means the male is diseased. It means death resulted. And here, if circle is crossed, or you can say line is drawn, slash is drawn, you can say, then it means female is diseased. This is the divorce case. Here is the consanguineous mating. It means mating within the relatives. Now here you can see, students, on the top, here you can see the first generation, and the mating is shown. If we connect the male, the square, with the circle, it means it shows mating. And the vertical line shows the offsprings, which are connected again with the horizontal line. So upper ones are parents, and the lower ones are the offsprings. Now here you can see, this is the child which is adopted in, and this is the child which is adopted out. Here you can see, this is the symbol which shows monozygotic twins, and here you can see dizygotic twins, and here zygosity is not known to us. So in this way, we can identify, we can study pedigree charts by using different symbols. Now students, how to study pedigree chart? Now here you can see, first of all, let us study what is given in your syllabus, that is study of autosomal dominant traits. So how to study autosomal dominant traits? So here I am going to give you one example, one problem. Here you can see, this type of chart will be given to you in your examination, and you you are supposed to study, and such type of questions being put on the basis of the following this chart. Okay, now here you can see students, here you can see, if we study this, so this is male, this is female, and horizontal line shows the mating, this is the vertical line, and to vertical line different individuals are attached. So you can say these are the children of this couple. Okay, so this is these are arranged in order of their birth as well. For example, first is the daughter, and then the son, and then the daughter. So these are three children of this couple, and here you can see this daughter got married with this male, and this son got married with this female. In the same way, this shows the mating, and this is the next generation of this couple. You can see. So here you can see three generations will be studied in this fertility chart. This is first generation, parental generation can be said, and second and the third generation. Now students, here you can see that how can we identify that what kind of trait is shown by this fertility chart. Is it autosomal dominant? Is it autosomal recessive? Or is it, or you can say, sex-linked recessive? Because these three are in our syllabus, so questions being put on the basis of these three pattern of inheritance. So what are the questions being asked? Here you can see the first question. Is the trait autosomal, recessive or dominant? Find out the genotypes of parents and offspring of all generations. Give two examples of your answer. Say, if your answer is autosomal dominant, so you are supposed to give example of autosomal dominant. If your example is autosomal recessive, then you are supposed to give example of autosomal recessive. So students, here, now you can see the solution of the problem 1. Here you can see. This is, you can say, autosomal dominant trait. How could you identify this is the autosomal dominant? Because here mother is affected. And you know that autosomal character can express itself even when it is in heterozygous condition. So this dominant trait can express itself in homozygous condition as well as in heterozygous condition. A single dominant allele is more than enough to express the trait. So here the mother is affected, or you can see a trait is seen in mother, and here you can see this is father, which is normal. So here the normal gene is recessive and the affected gene is dominant. So here you can see this is the son which received the dominant gene from the mother. So here you can see this is autosomal dominant, and it is heterozygous dominant. Why not homozygous dominant? Because 100% progeny are not affected. If the mother is homozygous dominant, then 100% progeny would be affected. But here, out of 1, 2, 3 offsprings, only 2 are affected, 1 is normal. So in this way, we can identify that mother is heterozygous dominant, not the homozygous dominant. Now here, students, you can see a single gene is more than enough to express the trait in son. So this is the, you can say, hint or the key point to identify that this is a trait which is controlled by autosomal dominant gene. Now, next is, genotypes are already shown. Here you can see the genotypes of parents. These are the genotypes of parents. This is recessive, homozygous recessive, then heterozygous dominant, then same, you can say this homozygous recessive, then heterozygous dominant, heterozygous dominant. So whatever the symbols asked, whatever the progeny asked, that are labeled over here. You can see all the genotypes are mentioned over here. And now what are the examples of autosomal dominant? Rolling of tongue. What is rolling of tongue? Rolling of tongue means a person can roll their tongue by just making U shape. So you can make your tongue U shape. So it means you are dominant. If you can't roll your tongue into U shape, it means you are recessive. You can say that trait is controlled by recessive alleles. So widow peak means just on the forehead you can see a wedge shaped structure. So this is what is called Willosby. And another autosomal dominant is myotonic dystrophy. It is a muscular disorder, genetic disorder. It is also autosomal dominant. If any of the parent has autosomal dominant trait, then the children got the disorder. So this is what is autosomal dominant. Now come to next study of autosomal recessive trait. Now here again come to the second problem. This is the second problem. So this chart may be given to you. So here you can see that parents are normal. Here you can see, how could you identify that this is autosomal recessive? Because your parents are normal. But how could the children got the disease? It means some genes are hidden in the parents. And when they come together, they start expressing themselves and the disorder or the trait can be seen. So here you can see, recessive genes can hide themselves in presence of dominant gene, or you can say this recessive gene can't express itself in the presence of dominant gene. But when the recessive gene comes in homozygous condition, then it expresses. So that is why parents are normal, but here you can see the children got the disease. Same with here. Here you can see parents are normal, but you can see the trait, the disorder in the next generation. So in this way we can identify that this is autosomal recessive. Now here you can see some genotypes are asked. So here you can see these are the parental genotypes. Here you can see this is the recessive gene. In presence of dominant, the parents could not show the trait because recessive gene could not express itself in the presence of dominant one. But when it comes in homozygous condition, here you can see it comes in homozygous condition, so it shows the trait. It shows the disorder, you can say. Here you can see, right? So in this way, examples are sickle cell anemia, thalassemia, phenylketonuria. These are the disorders, genetic disorders, which are autosomal recessive. Autosomal recessive means the mutated genes are present on autosomal chromosomes. Now students, come to next. Next is study of X-linked recessive trait. In your syllabus, only recessive trait is given, sex link, X link you can say. It means the gene is present on X chromosome and recessive trait is to be studied by you, which is given in the syllabus. Now come to the problem 3. Here you can see students, how could you identify that this is a sex link recessive trait? Here you can see parents are normal and the son has got the disorder or the disease. How come? It means mother might be a carrier. Mother might be a carrier. The X chromosome must have a mutated gene so that mutated gene passes to the son, because son receives X chromosome from his mother, not from the father. So whatever the defect present on X chromosome, that is received by son. So here you can see now when this male is going to marry with the female, then 100% children would be affected. How could it be possible? How the daughter becomes affected? Because here this lady is carrier of the disorder. So when you know carrier, because recessive gene is you can say recessive gene express itself when it comes in homozygous condition. So when it comes in homozygous condition, then female expresses. So, in case of males, X-linked inheritance shows holendric, you can say it shows somewhat, you know, hemizygous condition. X chromosome is actually hemizygous. What does it mean? Whatever the genes present on X chromosome, the counterpart alleles are not present on Y chromosome and vice versa. So, single recessive gene is more than enough to express in males, to express a particular trait in a male. That is why males are more, their percentage seen more as hemophilic, as colorblind, etc. And X chromosome is received from mother by the male. So here you can see this is the problem, and let us solve the answers of the questions. Now here you can see these are the genotypes of the parents. Because the gene is located on X chromosome, so you must use the symbol for male and female, and you know that males are represented by XY and females are represented by XX. So here mutated gene is present on one of the X chromosome. That is why female is normal, but she is carrier. She is not hemophilic, but she is a carrier of the hemophilia, so that it can pass that hemophilia to her son. Here you can see, she can pass the hemophilia to her son, and the son becomes hemophilic, though the father is normal, but because the mother has the mutated gene, so son becomes the hemophilic. Same with this, here you can see, daughter becomes hemophilic, means this lady is also carrier of hemophilia. That is why 100% progeny becomes hemophilic. So female becomes hemophilic only when father is hemophilic and mother is either hemophilic or carrier of hemophilia. She is normal but carrier of hemophilia. So in this way we can study that this sex linked, X-linked you can say, X-linked recessive disorder. And these are some examples: hemophilia, color blindness, red and green color blindness, specific color. Now come to next. The last one, the study of blood groups inheritance. So by the help of pedigree charts, we can also study blood group inheritance. Here you can see, this is one problem. Different problems can be given. This is one example only. So here you can see, this is father, this is mother. So father's blood group is O, mother's blood group is AB. So here you can see, this couple has two progeny. One is son, another is daughter. So the son is having A blood group. You have to find the blood group of this female, this daughter you can say. And this son got married to the female with O blood group. And you have to find the blood group of this individual of generation second. Third, I'm going to say, right? Okay. And then here you can see that this is the blood group given. You have to find the blood group 1. So here you have to find the genotypes of parents as the question indicates. You have to find the genotypes of individual of generation second with blood group O. Here you have to find the genotypes and A respectively. So you have to find the genotypes. These are the phenotypes. Phenotypes are physical expression of an individual, while genotypes are genetic makeup of an organism. So here you can see, let us study the problem, solution of the problem, genotypes. So genotypes of blood group O is homozygous recessive, and genotype of blood group A is heterozygous dominant. Same with this, if we talk about blood group 1, it is B, and it is heterozygous B. Why heterozygous B, not homozygous? Because in next generation, you can find O blood group. O blood group can only be seen when both the parents are heterozygous for a particular trait. Then you can only see O blood group. Or one of the parent is with O blood group and another must be with heterozygous A or heterozygous B. Then only O blood group can be seen in next generation. So this is the way how to identify O blood group. Though we already have done this chapter and we are very well aware of how the blood group inheritance resulted. Now students, here you can see what is the significance or application, or you can see utility of pedigree analysis. So students, pedigree analysis you can say is a key, or you can say is a very potent tool for genetic counselors to advise intending couples about the possibilities of having some genetic disorders in their children. This is very first point. Second point, by the help of pedigree analysis, we can study the Mendelian inheritance pattern, how the genes are inherited, no doubt with some modifications. Now, third is, it can also indicate the origin of a trait of or disorder, where the trait is originated. For example, if you talk about Queen Victoria, she was the carrier of hemophilia, and her son sons were, you can say, hemophilic. So because somehow the starting point of hemophilia was the Queen Victoria, we can say the royal family, Queen Victoria of England. So here you can see It can indicate the harm of marriage between close relatives may cause. So, close relative marriage should be avoided, because when it resulted, then homozygous recessive genes can come together, or you can say recessive genes can come together as homozygous, and you know that recessive gene can only express when they come together as homozygous. So this is what about pedigree analysis. These are some questions based on pedigree analysis. You go through them. Tomorrow you can ask these questions. So what are the questions? What is meant by pedigree analysis? What does the symbol square represent in a pedigree? Give an example of autosomal recessive trait. And the last one is, what is the importance of pedigree analysis? So students, go through these Viva and you can ask your queries tomorrow. This is for today only. So thank you and have a nice day.